Come here, let me talk to you for a second. Look, I bought these for you. These are yours. It's not gonna happen again, I promise.
Cause things got worse and way worse for me. See all the times she's cried, and all the time he's lied, saying how I'll never hurt you again. Yeah, but it's just lie after lie, they progress over time. Really, he don't give a fuck. It's certain pain that you caused inside. That makeup won't cover up insecurities, broken hearts, and regrets.
I smoke, I drink, I do my thing. These bitches hatin', so you know I got to make it plain. Don't do cocaine with your chick, my main. We stick together, true forever, yeah, you know we bang. I miss those days, shit was easy. If only I make it, keep this shit on repeat. Now that I done upgraded, I've been upstate, but y'all think I'm playing. And I got a hit now for these weak ass hoes who think I ain't slaying. Try me, and I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out. Try me, and I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out. These hoes, they know I'm on, it's my show. I know I'm better, Gucci sweater, Louis V, my bros. I chose this road, cause I know I'm cold. I'm on the level you can't handle, you can't steal this flow. I swear I want people to feel me, but I don't care. This is the real me. How can I give up? Hate is not enough to make them stop what I'm saying. And I gotta hit now for these weak assholes who think I ain't slaying. Try me, I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out. I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out.
See, I'm really getting tired of you. Wanna do everything but tell the truth. They be sleeping on me really when I'm in the booth. Sensational, yes, tasteful, insatiable. My name, baby. Come on, girl, let me drive you crazy. Done fighting, I wanna fuck tonight. So what's up tonight? I'm all dressed in white. I don't snort the white, but we can blow the green. Reconcile the new money team. Sophisticated, so it may look mean. I'm all about my cream and trying to chase my dream. God got me, so I'll never stop. Keep it real, never turn and pop. Ambitious mind like I'm pimple pop. Long as Cam got us, we'll never flop.
Try me, I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out. Try me, I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out.
This is Vianna Marie, and you're listening to Hoobazoo.com.
See? Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
This is blasphemy. This is madness. This is a booth.
Staring down, looking at the blood-stained concrete. You're the dead MC, lying at my feet. You took a 9mm rhyme straight to your mind. Damn, my better split. These witnesses my dime, so I make my way up the block. Get to home base and lock that up. Crack the cavassier and grab the phone. Call one of my troops up. Hope the soldier's homie says, yo, what's up, what's going on? Make it quick, cause I'm trying to get my stellar on. Nigga, you grow up in the... These lyrical assassins tried to pull a hit, and then boom, came a noise from the other room. It was the boys in blue with the SWAT crew. They got us locked up for lyrical murder. It's one of them charges that you never heard of. It's the booth, the booth, the booth, the booth. Yeah, it's the booth, the booth, the booth. Yeah, we're killing all your podcasts like the HIV virus. You want to battle this kid? Huh, don't even try this. Back the up, think again, count to 10. You want to grab that mic just to get done in? It's the booth, the booth, the booth, the booth. Yeah, it's the booth, the booth, the booth, the booth. Yeah, it's the booth.
Was he African?
African.
No. He was American, and he was like you. He looked just like you.
He's Jewish.
Just Jewish. Like
okay.
Him.
Jew. Okay. It's an odd crime for a Jew to commit.
Yeah, pretty docile.
Okay, so we have an African Jew wearing a hoodie.
No, you don't.
No.
No, that's not what I said. Is that what you heard me say? I said he looked like you. Do you look like an African Jew?
No, I look like a cop.
Yeah.
He was Caucasian.
All right, your boy, Sinister One, broadcasting live from the City of Champions. You are listening to The Booth, and I'm returning to the airwaves tonight with a vengeance. There's a lot of stuff going on. I want to thank everybody who's already in the chat waiting to listen to this show. I got a big thanks to my special guest last week, filmmaker Norm Mittman, who was on from Snowman Films. Great guy. We actually discussed Godzilla versus King Kong, which the trailer was released last week, and I am still ecstatic about it. I can't wait to see it. Also, I got to thank Branding Boston's Pretty Poison and Dro Casso, who hosted their Branding Boston event last week. Vianna Marie performed. It was a two-day event. Shout out to AMB, African Man Born, who performed before. Shout out to Maverick, who hosted the show from WJMN's 94.5. But I've got some guests already in the Zoom tonight for us. If you look down below and over to the left, if you look over to the left, you guys can see someone who I was doing the show with a while back, Karl Kafer. Also, if you guys remember this voice, this was the guy that had to cough up a couple of bets here that he lost when the Patriots went up against the Pittsburgh Steelers.
I should have worn that. I should have worn that for you.
You should have.
I'll continue to do that. I'll continue to lose. I'm okay with that.
You should have. And if you guys are watching the show right now, behind me, what's up, Vianna Marie in the chat? If you look behind me, what I'm going to try to do each week, this is Black History Month. And this week, since I've been involved with radio and doing this show now, I'm going to try to share four of the most influential black people in radio in over the time. And if you guys look behind me, you can see Sonny Joe White for Black History Month for radio here in the Boston area. Sonny Joe White was on WILD, which was like the major radio station for black listeners in 77. And then they started this network, Kiss 108, and Sonny Joe White went over there, and he changed the industry as we know it. Sonny Joe White is one of the most respected DJs in the history of radio. Sonny Joe White is well known for when Kiss 108 used to have these humongous giant concerts at Great Woods with all of these stars. And one year, Rod Stewart, if you guys all remember Rod Stewart, he came here for a concert for Kiss 108. And what happened was they decided that it was running late and Rod Stewart was going to pull out and not do the show. Which, at that time, he was the headliner of this concert. Sonny Joe White, live on air, chased down Rod Stewart's manager, ripped him apart on air live, for backing out and leaving the show. Then he caught up with Rod Stewart, and he lit Rod Stewart up so bad that Rod Stewart came back and performed, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, he came back and performed a New Year's Eve show for the city of Boston. That's how bad Sonny Joe White ripped him apart. He was a great guy. A lot of people learned on the Sonny Joe White. He was a great guy. So he is in the Radio Hall of Fame. Now, speaking of Hall of Famers, if you guys are looking down below, if you see her...
What the hell happened to
Jeannie, so she's kind of messed her camera up, but it's okay. She's on camera with us. Long Jeanne Silver. She is the AVN 2021 Hall of Famer, Adult Video Awards. She's been in the business a long time. She's on the talk with me and Karl. And I want to thank Karl for coming on. Yeah, you can just leave it like that. You're good. You're good. It's that psychedelic 70s feel. It's not that big of a deal as long as we've got you on. But she is a Hall of Famer, 2021 inductee for this year for ABN. And I just want to, first off, I got to congratulate you because that is a big achievement to be recognized for what you've done in the industry for what is, you know, for years. Now, I'm going to let people know why you were inducted into the Hall of Fame and what your contribution was to the adult film world.
Because I pegged the boy. No.
You did.
I the win is basically a win for the people with the disability community, my community. I was born with a congenital birth defect, and Hollywood didn't want people with birth defects back then. Now they do. But I ended up going into the adult film business, and my first centerfold or layout was a centerfold for Cherry Magazine without my prosthetic on. So I'm the first amputee porn star.
Nice. And how did, so back then, that was kind of, it was almost a little bit like taboo, would you say, right? Correct?
Oh my God, it was so, oh, yeah, I'm sorry. It was very taboo, very taboo. I mean, I got arrested in Rhode Island for sodomy, conspiracy to commit sodomy, conspiracy to circulate pornographic materials. I was arrested with Annie Sprinkle and—
oh, I remember that name.
And Queen Kong, who also used to go by the name of Matilda the Hun from wrestling. Hello, wrestling.
Yep.
Queen Kong also went by that name. We were all arrested in Rhode Island for obscenity charges because I put my stump somewhere that was considered... You know, it's okay to fist somebody. It's okay to put digits in somebody. Why is it so taboo to put a stump in somebody?
I know there's a lot of people... There's a lot of people right now, they've got a crazy, crazy visual. Now, here's the funny thing, and speaking about the hypocrisy and the taboo of the adult film industry, which cracks me up, and I will argue this with anybody from day one. For an industry that's so taboo and people down-talk it, people don't realize that there are probably almost everyday things that we have in this industry that we would never be able to use or have if it wasn't for the adult film industry. And I'm just going to just break it down real quick for people who don't even realize this. If it wasn't for the adult film industry, we probably wouldn't have a film industry at all, because it was the film, the dirty films that were made that's during silent film era that brought on this whole thing of production. Then we fast forward and we go from VCRs. When VCRs first hit, you couldn't afford a VCR. But what happened was adult videos came on VCRs. They came on cable, and it made this boom for cable. It made this boom for VCR tapes. I remember going into video stores, and they always had that little back room. And that back room was the most crowded room of all. That was the adult video room. And then I remember after VCRs came, we had this introduction to what was called DivX in high def DVDs. And I remember going to Circuit City, and I remember seeing this major news story that Disney was going to release their movies on DivX, but the adult industry was going to release their movies on high def DVD. And I said, man, if I'm buying stock, I'm going to DVD because that's going to kill Disney. And I remember somebody saying, no way, Disney's going to take off with DivX. DivX is going to be the next big thing. Guess what? No, it wasn't. The adult film industry blew up on DVDs and it never looked back. And right now we have the internet. And with the internet, it allowed people to bring porn and adult films into their home. And you see these things like Pornhub and RedTube and all of these sites. And the piracy. Now. It's massive crazy.
Piracy. Massive piracy, though.
Yes, there is. And you want to talk on that real quick? And I'll let Karl get in here. You want to talk? Because piracy has become, even though the success of porn is blown up right now, I've heard about the fact that piracy is even bigger.
Well, people go on the paid sites. They will film what they're paying, and then they'll go and just blast it everywhere else. At least during my era, they didn't have video cameras to go into the theater while someone's schlepping something off next to you in the seat. You know, ours was in the theater. Mm-hmm. So now you have it on DVD, or somebody, you know, can transfer it on and sell it bootleg. Do you know how many bootleg videos that I found of me?
Oh,
really?
Tons.
I'm like Long Jean Silver, but wait a minute. That picture is of me from Piggies. I was also like 8 years older. What was that?
Wow. Wow. Kyle?
A couple things. First, Jeanne, I do want to say congratulations. And also the sense that the handicapped are represented in this, and you've been doing that ever since. I remember seeing you. Oh, I had to be like 79 or 80 in that Sherry. And just said, oh, my God.
I also have
difficulties. I was born with CP. So, you know, I think that's a wonderful thing. And secondly,
when other people have disabilities, we kind of grow together as a community.
Oh, absolutely.
So what I take my win as a win for the disability community. Now, what they need to do is what they did with me back then. I wasn't just a niche performer. All my films weren't just about me being an amputee. I was also in mainstream adult film. Maybe not the lead, but I was a big part in them. So why not now these people who are doing the disability porn are only disabled people in them. They need to be allowed to expand into other. And that's what would be really great, because that's what I did. And I'm hoping that opens the doors.
And I agree with you. I think
it's so cool. Oh my God, this is too serious. Stop.
the other thing too, I wanted just to say to Keith is that it's rule 37. If there's new technology, there will be porn on it immediately.
That's right. That's right. And like I said, it's responsible for mostly every... Look, I remember when cell phones took off, and the first big thing that was on smartphones was Two Girls in One Cup. Everybody who had an iPhone when it first came out, it wasn't who you could talk to or what you could watch. The first big video that everybody was downloading on their iPhones or Android phone was Two Girls... One Cup. It was crazy how popular that was mainstream, and it blew up. I remember people getting phones just so they could try to watch it. It was crazy. But again, like I said,
I must be the only person that doesn't buy porn.
Listen, dear, I don't think you need to. You have to.
I don't buy it. I don't watch it. It's like been there, done that. You know, it's not as fun as the people think it is.
No, it's not.
It's not. And I've heard the stories. I've seen it. Yeah, it's a lot of work. Well,
over at DLN, we've done several interviews, not just with Jeanne, but
with Richard Bola and several people, and stories that I've heard over the years. You know, I mean, it's hard work.
Yeah, what about guys getting their balls burnt while the lighting guy gets in?
Yeah.
You know, I mean,
I've heard that. And the thing is, that's...
Keith is like, I love
so, hold on. So I used to do these fake workman comp forms as a joke back in the day. And I used to do workman comp forms for porn stars as a joke. And now that you said that, it makes me like, oh my God, could you imagine filling out a workman's comp form because your balls got burned by the lighting guy? Yeah, source of injury, the lighting guy. Description.
Falls on your head, you know, it's like there's all kinds of work hazards.
Oh my God. Know? And you guys aren't, porn industry still fighting to become union, right? The actors and actresses, aren't they still?
They've got a union started. It's just not widely recognized. I've been asked to join, but since I'm so far out of the loop with majority of it, mm-hmm. I mean, it's progressed much further. And it would be great that they actually had a union to protect everybody's health rights and, mm-hmm. and lawyers and just learning how to maintain your money and not end up doing drugs and being an asshole.
So my question to you is, okay, so why is the Screen Actors Guild hypocritical in not covering adult film industry under the Screen Actors Guild? Everything, just because of what you do doesn't take away from what is done. There's acting is still involved. So I don't understand this. Why does the Screen Actors Guild union not cover adult film stars? There's really no reason why not, other than they just don't want to be connected to what the product is. And that to me is hypocritical. It makes no sense in my book.
Very
hypocritical, but that's what it is. That's exactly why.
Why haven't the adult industry gotten together and taken them to court? I'd take them to court. I would get somebody to represent the adult film entertainment world and bring that argument right to the highest court if possible and say, hey, we need representation. This, you guys should be doing this for us.
That's the problem, is finding somebody who's actually willing to represent the community without, you know, with pure intentions, not mm-hmm. just selfish reasons. You know, we need somebody who actually feels that we deserve a right. And I believe we do. We're on camera, we're on sets, we have dialogue, yeah. we have all of that, you know? So I don't understand it either. Maybe in my lifetime it will happen, but they better hurry the fuck up.
Because that's my opinion. I would say, I don't know why. And you've had a lot of people in the porn industry, adult film industry, who have been in mainstream media. They've been up front. I mean, there's a lot of people who could have represented the Screen Actors Guild side of that. I just think it's just crazy of all these years that it hasn't been discussed or it hasn't been approached. Like I said, I would take them to court. I would get a group together and fight this all the way to court for representation. That would be me.
I think it's something that should be spoken to. I can talk to some of the girls and see what they're doing. Mm-hmm. Definitely. Maybe you should get some of them on. My thing fell apart. It's just whatever. I don't know. Okay.
It's all the unvarnished gene.
We're doing pillow talk with Jeanne. Here's your sexy 60-year-old.
Damn right.
So what are some of your best moments during your time? I mean, you came up during the 70s had to be a crazy time in the porn industry. That was, there's the dog. Dogs always love to steal the show.
Really? Kit, go on. Go lay down. Go to your room. Go on. Thank you. She just wanted kisses. My whole time during that was like, I mean, come on, I'm in my 20s. I mean, Did I learn anything? I learned how to stay out of jail. I mean, it was the sexual revolution. I mean, we did it. We put it out there. It was highly illegal when we did it.
Absolutely.
I loved the traveling and dancing. Mm-hmm. I danced in Brockton, by the way.
Really?
I did.
Uh-oh.
And I'm not sure if it was Alex's.
Alex's in Stoughton, 138. I've been there many a times when I was younger.
So was I.
I forget the person who put that place on the map. Club Alex's was put on the map nationwide because of Chesty Morgan.
Chesty Morgan, yeah.
Yeah, she put that place on the map.
So, yeah, I enjoyed doing that. I got to travel with doing that, just meeting people, having fun, the people I worked with. Of course, my one loss recently was losing Carter Stevens.
Yeah.
That was super hard for me. The one blessing I will say about the AVN Hall of Fame is I was very depressed, and then I saw his memoriam. They did the memoriam. They showed a picture of him, and I broke down. Oh my God! I was like crying like crazy. But then I thought about it, and it was like him and I got to do it together. It was our one last project together.
Yeah.
Now, so I looked at it that, you know, we were both on, you know, the same time. I got Hall of Fame. He got rest in peace. But we got to do it together. So.
Yeah, that's still a good thing. Matt Cameron from Maddie C Sports for You and Me show, he's in the chat. He said, what's up? He says he remembers trying to watch the scrambled channels and so you could just get a glimpse of boobs. I remember that. Starcase. Yep, you had to switch through. You'd sit there and wait for that moment. Oh, I seen it!
Oh, my God! There's a boob! Oh, my God!
So I remember, you know, and it's funny because porn has been such a big part of society behind the scenes. And I remember Marilyn Chambers, one of my biggest memories, Marilyn Chambers made a porn movie that was huge. And then she tried to make this transition into regular acting. And she starred in a film called Rabid, which was a horror film. And it really didn't, her career really didn't pan out after that as far as being a regular actress. But have you ever thought of trying to jump in and maybe do some regular acting if you caught the bug or no?
Really? No? Wait a minute.
Oh, Clownado. Thank you. That's what we wanted to see. Clownado.
Stop her into that one.
Can I say something about it, Gene, or you
don't? Go for it. Go for it.
One minute. Just let me just say one thing. It seems the trend for most people that are in my business, women, we all end up in a damn horror movie.
Oh, yeah. That's very true of most of them.
To horror.
Yeah.
Or B, D, C-rated hoarder. Horror. Just whatever. It was a hoot. And well, thank you for the Latin lessons.
Yes, I actually taught Jeanne. Jeanne had, in the script, she had to do all this Latin, and she posted on Facebook, you know, she didn't know how to pronounce it. I'm a choir director, and I said I'd help her out. And so, like, we had, what, 4 or 5 phone calls trying to get you to say it right.
And he's yelling, yeah, and you're yelling at me, all, you're doing it wrong. And I'm like, we just be, you know, it's like, you're saying it like an Italian. Well, Latin is Italian, isn't it?
Let's remember, Abbo.
What are you? Huh?
I love you. That is what that means. So, there you go. But you,
oh my God.
I think you did a great job in Clownado. And of course, we had you and Todd on. And I think you ought to do more of that, to be honest. Seriously, you were a lot of fun in that movie.
I'd like to do stuff like that, but there's my hand, my arms. Wait, look at my hand.
Yeah.
And no, if I had to shift, I had to shift my hand.
And by the way, Joel Weinkoop says hello. He wanted me to.
Hi, Joel.
We had him on a couple of weeks ago, and he said, you got to say hello to Jeannie.
Oh, that's sweet. He's a sweet person.
Yes, he is. Very much so.
Good stuff. So again, guys, you all are watching Karl Kafer, and you're watching Jeanne Silver. She is the AVN 2021 Hall of Fame inductee. If you're out there on adult video world and, you know, Googling or searching, you want to search her name up, check her out. How long did your career span before we let you go? How long were you exactly in adult films?
About 10 years, to be honest, which was quite a bit. But I only did 23 films in those 10 years. Those standards, not a lot. But I also was famous for taking breaks and getting healthy and then coming back. And then party, 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 and then taking a break. And, you know, I think that's what kept me survive, you know, that and then getting pregnant. And, you know, it's like, oh, I'm quit.
That brings an end to it. PTA meetings must be pretty interesting when your mom comes. <to you. laughs> Parent-teacher conferences.
Brownies was a lot of fun. And then trying to keep it hidden from my daughter until she was in college.
Get out. You didn't tell her until she was in college?
No, and she called me. And she goes, Ma, have you ever heard of Long Jean Silver?
Yes.
I hung the phone up on her.
What was that? We got a bad line. Click.
And I was like, what do I do? And I'm like, okay, well... You know, she goes, no, I think it's cool. You have a wiki page. And I was like.
You know, that's one thing we should mention is Irene is a lovely, she's into modeling now and things like that.
Photography, mixed martial arts.
Oh, damn.
Wrestling. She does it all.
Yeah, she's something.
Crazy stuff.
You should
wow.
be very proud.
Oh, my hands are shaking. Wow. Okay.
So, all right, we're going to let you say if anybody has any social media that they could follow you on or, you know, check you out.
I'm just on Facebook under Jeanne Silver.
Okay.
With random profiles, so it's never the same. And Long Jeanne Silver on Instagram. Okay. I have a Twitter, but I haven't been able to get on it for 7 years.
There's some joke there. There's some joke there, but I'm going to keep it to myself.
I know, but I didn't get banned, okay? I was not banned, so we're not going to go there.
Yeah, I know. We're going through that right now. A lot of people getting banned on social media, so, yeah. Man, good stuff. Karl, before we get out of here, I'm going to let you say what you got going on because you got your podcast and the stuff that you do, and it's great to hook up with you.
Yeah, and absolutely. So we've got Deviant Legion Network, and I also run the Incredibly Strange Films podcast, which is connected to the Facebook group with over 300,000 members.
Nice.
Yeah, tell me about it. So on Friday, we're doing a retrospective of the career of Hal Holbrook.
Nice.
And we're going to have... author and personal friend of Hal's, Mark DeWitziak, on with us, and that'll be me and Limes. On Tuesday, we've got the ISF podcast, and we've got guests for that. But the big one is going to be March 1st. And March 1st, we are going to have as a guest on the show, Limes with a Terror with a Twist of Limes, hosted by Limes Marshall, we're going to have Dee Wallace on.
Whoa, Dee Wallace from The Howling.
Yes, and E.T. and Cujo.
Wow. I'll do that show.
Oh, I'll do that show. Stuff.
You can watch
I actually have a show I will PM you on, Jeannie, because we've got an author by the name of Jeffrey Escoffier who has done social studying of porn.
Oh.
And that sort of thing. So I'm actually going to contact you on that. But
Do you know how many people? Yeah, I've had so many people write their dissertations and papers on me.
Wow.
Okay.
That's interesting. Wow.
It is. One of these days, I'm going to sit down and read them.
Well, this particular gentleman focuses more on the gay porn.
Gay porn, kind of, sort of.
Yeah, you did. I know. I've seen a lot of your movies, okay? I'm just like, you know that.
That's like some of the gay boys like me.
I think everybody loves you.
Just going to put that out there. All
I think you just made Keith blush again.
Yeah.
Do we want to share that story or not, Keith? I'll leave it up to you.
She's killing me. She's killing me.
Do you want to share that story the first time you ever met Jeannie on when you were producing me and Stephen Ronquillo?
You can. Go for it.
Okay, so Stephen and I were doing a show, and we got to give a shout-out to Stephen because without Stephen, I would have not met Jeannie or you.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Stephen.
Hi,
shout
Stephen.
Out.
So anyway, we were talking, and I was telling the story that I was living in New York in the 80s and would go by the show world all the time on 42nd and 8th. And you said something particularly that absolutely made Keith just bust.
What did I say? Oh, my God, don't leave me in. I have no memory.
Okay. There must be a river of cum under that building.
Oh, my God, yes. Oh, the amount of jizz that was all over that place. I mean, you walk out and it was like...
Yeah.
Oh, it was horrible. I hated it. I felt bad for the mop guys.
Yeah, really?
What's up, Patrick Goldstone? I see you chat. So, guys, we've been talking to AVN Hall of Famer 2021, Jeannie Silver and Karl Kafer. I got to thank these guys for coming on real quick. It's been a great interview, guys, and it's been good stuff. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take a quick break. I'm going to play a trailer for you guys, Godzilla vs. Kong, and then we're going to be back on the show. But again, you want to check her out on Instagram and Facebook, and Karl Kafer, you can look him up on Facebook and check out his show. Dee Wallace is amazing. That she was like the 80s mom, so I can't wait to see that coming on. So I'm going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with more Booth after this.
Keith, thank you very much.
All right, guys, we're good. We're clear. Thank you. Good show.
We have to take it.
No. It was a good show. Good stuff. Thanks for coming on, guys. All right, take care. All right. Take care. No problem.
We need
All right, Kong. Bye.
The world needs him to stop what's coming. And this child... She's the only one he'll communicate with.
I knew that they had a bond. She had nowhere to go, so I made a promise to protect her. And I think that in some way, Kong did the same. Godzilla.
Godzilla's out there and he's hurting people and we don't know why.
There's
something provoking him that we're not seeing here.
I'm of the same opinion.
The myths are real.
Yeah.
There was a war.
Come on.
And they're the last ones standing.
I keep reaching for greatness because I'm built from it.
Who bows to who?
Nobody gonna stop for me.
Here we go.
Kong bows to no one.
Here we go.
I got chills, they're multiplying, and I'm losing control. Godzilla versus Kong. Oh my goodness gracious. Look, I can't wait. I can't wait for this film to debut. I just can't. What's up, Maddie Cameron? Maddie Cameron and Kevin Tachi from WATD are going to be joining me this Saturday for a special Super Bowl preview show Saturday afternoon. We go live. So you want to check us out. I can't wait to break down the Super Bowl discussion with you guys. But I got to thank my guests who were just on, Karl Kafer and AVN Hall of Famer 2021 inductee, Jeanne Silver, long Jeanne Silver, adult film star. Great stuff. We kept it. We kept it as PGR as we could. So this is going to be a good show to go back and watch. So as we get into this show now, as you guys mentioned, I want to mention, let me just pull this back down here because I got to give props. I mentioned it earlier. If you missed it, if you're looking at my background, Sonny Joe White, Kiss 108, DJ, Black History Month. Every week I'm going to try to focus on somebody up here on my background for Black History Month. And as you saw before the show kicked off tonight, you guys saw a clip from the film, the autobiography of Miss Jane Pittman starring Cicely Tyson. This was a film that I remember seeing very young in school. And it was one of these movies that your parents made you sit your ass down and watch when it came on. No matter when it came on, this movie came on. My mom and my pops made me and my brother sit down and watch this film. The funny thing is parents, a lot of parents don't do that shit today. Parents don't make their kids sit down and watch something that can inspire or entertain, and not just entertain them, but teach them shit. A lot of parents need to go back to that. Because I remember there was a lot of films that my mom and dad made Eye on the Prize, which was a documentary on PBS about Dr. Martin Luther King. Every time that came on Channel 2, my mom would sit us down, we'd be watching it. Boom. You're watching this. And you sat and you watched, you didn't complain, you didn't do nothing. And lots of times you ended up liking it. I remember when Roots came on, my parents made me watch Roots the whole week. We got to stay, and they tricked us too, because Roots came on like a Sunday night. It was a 5-episode miniseries. And you know how my dad tricked us? He said, y'all can stay up late and not have to go to bed at 8 o'clock. You're going to be able to stay up late and watch a movie. We get to stay up late and watch a movie. We watch Roots. The whole week, my dad made us watch Roots. And we learned a lot. I remember going to school and talking about Chicken George. Remember going to school and talking about Kuta Kinte taking off and getting his foot cut off. Remember watching Roots and knowing that the only real character that you knew was John Amos from Good Times. And dude from The Rookies. Oh my God, Monty Moore with us, fam. Yo, you said it, my grandparents. You know my grandparents, Monty Moore family. He knows all about Jane Pittman and the Roots. Grandma Hayes making us sit there and watch it at the house. Monty Moore, he's family. He can co-sign on that one. He knows all about watching Roots up in my grandma's crib. Yeah, rest her soul, boy. But yeah, man. I remember my dad sit me down and make me watch Shaka Zulu when that came on in Shogun. My dad made me watch all types of stuff, man. Made us watch it. He wanted us to get education like we never got education like never before. So before we get into this show, Michael Douglas Barreto is one of my sponsors. He fixes my controllers when I send them out. So if my Xbox controllers break or something happens, they got a drift, I send it out. Within 48 hours, I got that back, and I'm back to gaming. And we've got some big news here in gaming. I'm real happy because you all don't have to see the meme of me crying anymore because I don't have an Xbox, because I was able to score an Xbox Series X finally. Finally. So I hooked it all up, downloaded all my stuff, and I was able to game on Sunday night. So I'm real, real happy. So you guys don't have to be in my Facebook private messages asking me if I got an Xbox. Y'all don't have to be in my Xbox private messages talking about your boyfriend got one and your man got one and did you get one yet? Don't be asking me all that stuff no more because I got one. Y'all can stop asking me because I got one. All right? So Michael Douglas Barreto, MDB Electronics, man. Holding it down. I'm ecstatic to have him on here. Also, Rebel Rom, that's my cousin. Check out her clothing line, Rebel Rom at rebelrom.com. It's made for the culture. She's got some good stuff. I'm actually going to start getting some pictures of some stuff of her stuff to put on here instead of just this ad so you guys can kind of see what's going on there and order your stuff. Also, tacticaltargetsystems.com. Hey, in my free time, sometimes I like to just go down to the range and just hang out with some buddies, because I got a lot of buddies who, you know, they carried and whatever. But I like to go down to the range with them. And I actually wanted some targets for myself when I go to the range with my buddies. So I saw this company here. He makes zombie targets. And in some states, you can't use humans as your targets. In some states, it's against the law. Some states, like Massachusetts, where it's really strict, a lot of clubs will not let you use anything that resembles a human or humanoid. But some places will allow you to use zombie targets. Now, he patented this. He's the guy that's got this. It's a great zombie target. If you look at the picture there, you can see that the bodily organs are visible, so you can do the headshot and it tells you that's a zombie kill zone in the head, and then you've got the liver and the pancreas and the heart and all that stuff. Check him out. He's great company, Don Robinson. I actually had a great conversation with him. He's an LAPD officer, retired. He's seen a lot. He knows a lot. He's been through a lot. He's a guy that's been on. Great conversation I had with him. We talked for almost a whole half hour on my ride home last week. Good guy. Good stuff. He loves R-Squared and Ken Diesel. So I'm going to try to get this guy on with us and maybe talk with us about some of the things that he's seen during his time as an LAPD police officer. The stuff he told me. And I don't want to say it on air because, you know, this was just stuff that we talked about. So hopefully I can get him on the show and we can check this out. In the news booth, I'm going to jump in the news booth. This picture right here is at the Avon Home Depot. This Avon Home Depot is, this woman was a Home Depot Karen. When I first got this, she was a Karen. And I didn't know who she was. But what happened was somebody sent me a thing and said, hey, this person is this. And I was like, what, really? So I'm going to show you guys the video that will explain who the Home Depot Karen is. And you guys are going to be like, wow. So hold on. Let me just pull up the picture here. Home Depot Karen right there. And then let me get this video up for you guys so you can check this out real quick, because this is crazy stuff. This is actually going to be part of my Are You Serious segment. That we unveiled. So, Are You Serious? Featuring Home Depot Karen, and she has been introduced and identified. So, here we go.
Are you guys in line? Are you coming? The people behind you.
This is all a lie.
Can you please wear your mask for safety purposes? It's in a state law.
All a lie. That's it. Chinese communist party. That's right. Yep. Yes, it is. Take your mask off. Take your mask
It's against the state mandate. You gotta be safe.
It's a lie.
You gotta be
Go
safe.
Look at the box. Look
hey,
at the
you
box.
Should take your meds.
Nobody cares how you're all right. Please. Look you at the box. Please. It's a lie. It's an absolute lie.
Meanwhile, at the local Home Depot.
I didn't know there was just like people like that.
No, no, she's been here.
Oh, she has.
I just forgot about it.
Okay, have a nice afternoon.
Bye.
Be safe.
Bye.
Be safe.
Why is it historic? It's historic because MLB the Show is a game that's produced by Sony. It's put out by Sony. And I can't wait for this game to hit the field. It's going to be awesome. It's going to be great. And the fact that a Sony game is premiering on Xbox is just incredible. What's going on, Dave Haggerty? What's going on, Eric? Moving on into the news booth. Matthew Stafford trade. The Rams sent 2 first-round picks and a 3rd-round pick and Jared Goff to the Lions. This was a crazy trade. Because Deshaun Watson's still out there looking to be traded. So it's obvious that whatever the Texans give up for Deshaun Watson is going to be ridiculous. Ridiculous. It's just going to be crazy. It's going to be crazy. So we'll see after this. Also in the news booth, we're actually moving into Biden bombshells, to be honest. We're going to move into Biden bombshells. Will the U.S. Capitol get a permanent security fence? Capitol Police are looking to maybe erect a permanent security fence around the White House after the insurrection on January 6th. Will that happen? I don't know. A lot of people were starting rumors and saying this was a Biden thing. It wasn't a Biden thing. Biden didn't have anything to do with this, suggesting this came right from the Capitol Police. So anybody who's spreading these rumors, stop it. Knock it off. But in Biden bombshells, Biden administration puts a hold on Trump arms sales to the UAE. For those who don't remember, President Donald Trump had received a Nobel Peace nomination for unifying the Middle Eastern countries. Guess what? The only reason why they signed off and got cozy with each other is because Trump promised to sell them our arms on the cheap. Not our old stuff, like we usually sell everybody, our old stuff. He was trying to sell our new shit. From planes to weapons to advanced weapon systems. Nope, that ain't happening. Biden come in, the administration came in with full backing from the military. That ain't happening. They're going to put a hold on that. And we seen it coming. We knew that was coming. It wasn't happening. Biden also, during his first week, he signed executive orders on immigration, and he's going to reunite the families that were divided at the borders where the kids are in cages. He's going to try to get a task force together to unify these. It's going to be hard because these people are spread out all over the place. Some people have died. Some children have died. So it's going to be real hard to unify these families, but he's put a task force in place, and we'll see what happens there. But Biden did drop the ball this week. Biden brought back a bill that will allow transgenders to be in the military and transgenders to compete in sports. Now, I have no problem with transgender people. Let me just put that out there first. No problem with transgender people. I understand the whole situation. I actually was involved with the situation with my dad. He had to go through a situation almost 20 years ago when a gentleman took 4 weeks of vacation and came back as a woman. Because he went through transgender surgery, and my dad was part of this whole thing as his boss. The thing here that bothers me with transgender is on the competition field of sports. Even though a male going to become a woman takes estrogen, there is still a scientific advantage, biological advantage there in sports. And we've seen it time and time again, where biological males who have now transitioned into becoming a woman have just strictly dominated. There's a lawsuit here, as you can see, in Connecticut, where 3 students have filed discrimination suits because a male who is transgender broke track records running as a woman. There was a young boy in Texas who became a female and ran right through the whole women's wrestling squad. Now, I talked to Mike Varner about this over Facebook. Mike Varner teaches down at Max. He teaches MMA. And he said, because in one of these situations, the MMA fighter, she actually eventually lost to a biological woman. And what Mike said is what eventually happened was she took a fight where the person was trained better and was more knowledgeable in the sport of MMA. So I am like, wow, that does make sense. But in some cases, again, there's still that advantage. So what do we do here? And this is going to be some type of discussion. Do we start? I was leaning more towards having their own league, but then it gets into this whole legality of segregation yet again. You know what I'm saying? So it's tough. It's not going to be an easy fix. It's a tough one when it comes down to sports. It's tough, and it's something to keep an eye on. It's times are changing, and you know, we just don't want transgender males going into women's sports and dominating because they couldn't cut it as a man in the male sport. Because trust, I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty damn sure that there's some men who've gotten and became transgender and knew this for a fact. So I'm not gonna say there's good and bad people. There's both sides to this story. I know when you go for weight loss surgery, you have to go and see a psychiatrist. You have to go and see somebody to talk about your issues, because sometimes losing the weight and getting weight loss surgery doesn't help with the mental issues. So I'm pretty sure it's the same thing when you go for transgender. So it's gonna be real interesting. It's gonna be a real interesting topic of discussion. And let's see what happens here. But I firmly believe that transgender males do have an advantage in women's sports, and I think somebody really needs to think about it. I've seen some situations where people were hurt, and it's not good. It's not good. So moving on, this was the story I shared earlier with the Redders. They bought a billboard in Times Square to troll the hedge fund investors and the people that they're making broke right now. So this is great stuff. I think it's hilarious. It's funny. And that's about it. I'm gonna get ready to get out of here and hold it down. But before I go, guys, want to check out the Sinister One Productions beanies. Those are the Sinister One Production beanies by Branded Bills, and they're great. They're selling, they're going out. I just sold 3 last week to someone, and usually I'll post their pictures up. So what I'll do is I'm just gonna share with you guys. Daryl Smith, thank you, man, for showing your support, showing your love of the Sinister One Productions. Jamie Canfield, showing his love and support with the Sinister One Productions beanie. Corey the Barber, my barber. Props to you, man, for making me look good every week. Corey the Barber down there at Eastside Cuts. There's nothing like a hot... Look, I don't just get the shave. I get the shave, then you put the cream on it, and then you get the hot towel. He goes in, he gets the hot towel and wraps the hot towel. And that hot towel, man, it's like every little bit of stress. Once that hot towel hits your head and those pores open up, it's like every little thing that was bothering you goes away. It just goes away. It's nothing like a lineup and that hot towel and that head shave. I'm just letting you know. Then he puts that alcohol on. Good stuff. So I got to give a shout out to my man, Corey the Barber down there at Eastside Cuts, man. Rocking the Sinister One Productions beanie. Also, UFC fighter Peter Barrett showing some love. Sinister One Productions hat, UFC fighter. How many people out there can talk about that? Good stuff. Peter Barrett going to be back in the octagon again. There he is again, masked up. Being COVID, showing his COVID awareness. What's up, Peter? Showing you. Family representing Rebel Rom Clothing, as you've seen before the show, one of the great sponsors of this show. That's my cousin's son in the picture. He's rocking his Sinister One beanie. So we want to jump on that. There's my stepson, Ryan Beeson, with his Sinister One beanie. My artist, Vienna Marie, showing some love. She's sporting her Sinister One beanie. Travis Partington, Oscar Mike Radio, holding it down, showing off his Sinister One beanie. And there's Matt Cameron, who's going to be on with me this Saturday. Matty C Sports for you and me. Man, this dude's been doing good stuff, boy. Good stuff. He's going to be on with me to talk Super Bowl on Saturday afternoon, so I got good stuff from him. Can't wait. He's rocking his Sinister One Productions beanie. And again, if you get a chance, check out Oscar Mike Radio on Thursday nights. Matty C Sports for you and me. 2 great podcasts holding it down. And again, Michael Douglas Barreto, MDB Electronics, holding it down for us yet again. That's the show for this week, everybody. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. good stuff. I'm pretty ecstatic that you all was with me tonight. And good stuff. It's just great to be out here this week and hold it down with you guys. And to be honest, I'm going to just take my ad down real quick because I just want to show you guys again for Black History Month. Sonny Joe White, rest in peace, man. You've been missed. You've actually would have been, I think you would have been 66 this year. I think you would have been 66. But again, Sonny Joe White, Kiss 108 FM. He was right up there with Dale Dorman. Some great people. And as I said, every week I'm going to be putting somebody up here for Black History Month as we count down our 28 days of Black history. So Sonny Joe White, man, it's just great to know that I listened and grew up listening to you for many, many years. And now I'm getting to do this thing here on this podcast. And I was doing stuff on WXBR and WBT, knowing that you were one of the guys that inspired me. So shouts out to him. Other than that, all I got to say is keep an eye out. Vianna Marie's got some new music coming, and we got some performances coming. And if you get a chance, check us out on YouTube and give us a subscribe if you missed the show. And other than that, I think it's about time for SpongeBob to take me home and say peace. So SpongeBob, do me a favor, take us home.
Well, see you next Tuesday.
Thank you for listening to The Booth on Hoobazoo and HatcherRadio.com. Please follow the Facebook page and subscribe to the podcast at Apple Podcast, iHeartRadio, and Spotify. The Booth is a Sinister One production hosted by Sinister One.
I've got to start hanging out with friends that are a little more intelligent and understand politics and stuff. It's just that I'm up on this level up here, and all my friends are down here. Me, meh. You guys, meh. Maybe a little more down in here. Screw you guys, I'm going home.
I smoke, I drink, I do my thing. These bitches hating, so you know I got to make it plain. Don't do cocaine with your chick, my main. We stick together, true forever, yeah, you know we bang. I miss those days, which was easy. If only I made it, bitch, don't repeat. Now that I done upgraded, I've been upstate, and y'all think I'm playing. And I got a hit now for these weak assholes who think I ain't slaying. Try me, and I'll probably end up laughing, cause I never back down. I'm that chick with a clean ass whip, I don't need that shit, cause I got my own now. I get hurt, I get tired of fussing, fighting, guess I gotta crack down. Don't mess with me, cause on everything, I'ma have to bring the whole city out.
WHOOBAZOO.com.
Enter website.